Easy people. Strada Brasov. Strada Brasov. That is the name of the street we are currently on. But we're not in Brasov, we're in the city of Cluj. The reason I've given you that street name right there is because the other day I found myself in this area by chance, although you could say there is no such thing as a chance. An opportunity. I was meant to come here. Anyway, so I'm here, and the reason I'm here in the residential area is because some of the buildings here are incredible. They are really impressive. They've got all of the antiquitech, all of the Tartarian-esque buildings, and to see it in a residential area really is a crucial part to the jigsaw, because it's all well and good pointing at the power stations, the cafodes, the huge churches, the governmental buildings, all of that that goes with it, that are generating the overall source of the electromagnetism that's being harnessed from the ether. But to see it in the residential way, so that we know that it's feeding to these buildings, really is a crucial part of the jigsaw. So anyway, that is enough of me waffling on, and check that out in the background, right on cue. Let's go and take a wander up this residential street. So there you can see a modern day one, which is potentially a renovation just to fit in with what is here. And what we have over this side of the street, just there, you can see an original. Now you can see the difference. Look at the antiquitech on top of the dome. Even the material of the dome itself, it's different. It's not the tiles that are used in a modern sense. This, I have absolutely no doubt, would be an excellent conductor of electricity. Even on the modern day ones, you can see still resemblance to the antiquitech that would sit on top of these domes. But this one, as I was just showing you, what would be the reason to build that on a residential property unless it served a purpose? What reason could you have for building anything like that unless it served some kind of purpose? And then you also have on the other side of the road, not the antiquitech, but it's a mudflood style building, and you'll see many of these on this street that go deep, deep into the ground. Just more evidence to support the notion of some kind of event that happened, that literally buried the old world. Just looks so out of place, really. It can't be decoration, it just cannot. Does not explain it. Here we have modern day renovation, and you can see it's a wood structure, but the home control banner there, I hope you can see that, it's a really, really bright day here today. The home control banner, I'm guessing, is any renovations that take part in this street have to fit in with what was already here, and these are the buildings that I'm more interested in. We're looking at the older ones that haven't been renovated, that haven't been updated, that haven't had modifications of some sort. And we still get many of these antiquitech points on the structures. There's a final image of what this property will look like. And all it is just the one antiquitech point. The actual spire itself, it's not like these ones. This is a different material altogether, which I would say is a conductor of electricity, copper, iron, perhaps something else that we're not fully aware of, but a conductor of electricity nonetheless. Wow, check this building. Not a residential one, but on the same street. Look at that. You can see the brickwork underneath the rendering. Gorgeous building. And lower levels. Not too sure if I'm allowed in there, but you can see the entrance. See the entrance right there? That is lower levels. Hello, hiya. Is this opera? Opera?
No, not opera.
Ah, where opera?
No, no, everywhere. No, inter this, no.
Ah, no, not here. The outside rendering just makes it seem as though it's nothing important, not really anything of significance, but underneath that rendering, I would suspect, is the old world Tartarian red brick. There we have another spire there. Look at that in the distance, can you see that? But the actual copper or iron domes, the extravagant domes, once a renovation has taken place, they are removed. They aren't put back on. All that is put back on the restoration projects is the very, very small Antiquitec, which is still good, still gives us an indicator, but to lose the dome, the extravagant dome, that really detracts from what these buildings are all about. Just at the other side of this structure, I wanted to bring your attention to the ornamentation on top of that roof there. Now you can see where the weathercock's been added. This is a modern day thing that they've done. And you can see, it's mudflood buildings. These are mudflood buildings. Now, of course, they've been modernized. This is a very affluent area, so people pay for modernization. That is what people like, not everybody. But you can just tell the actual structure itself, lower level. Lower level, original foundations, much like the one opposite. Also see that is a repurposed door right there, a lot lower, with this type of Antiquitec antiquity, just what you would expect to see. That is not the front door, that is a repurposed door. And just over the other side of the road, much of the same. There you have just a little glimpse of the dome, and then another smaller spire at the side, and you can see that that aerial antenna, Antiquitec, that has been snapped away or lost on purpose. Wow. Look at this renovation project. I'm not too sure if you can see, just in between the cement, just here in this pillar. Those bricks don't look like they've just been laid. It's like some sort of original foundation of some sort. And then this is the level that we're at today. Little bit of improvisation here, guys. Just want to show you so you can see the modern day renovation that we were looking at earlier, made of wood, all from wood. But this original building right here, underneath the rendering, it's the red Tartarian brick. The brick that can store energy. Well, guys, just a shorter video today because I want to keep this residential area of Cluj totally separate to the city of Cluj. There are many, many Tartarian masterpieces in the old town, in the city centre. And I'm just about to make my way there right now. And we'll do that in a second part. Anyway, hope you've enjoyed the small examples. Very, very important examples. But I hope you've enjoyed the small examples that I've shown you along this residential area here. And really, as I said, just another piece to the jigsaw. And an important piece, very, very important piece. Anyway, hope you have a blessed and wonderful day. I will see you all on the next video. Take care. One love to the people.